Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, the whole reason why people get attached to objects is because they're so difficult to acquire. So our little crazy monkey brains equate, you know, some shiny thing that's very expensive but difficult to get to being a worthy goal. Because we're in constant competition. Just basic alpha male chimpanzee behavior. And you show that person is the big giant rock that came from the fucking mountains of South Africa, and the slaves chipped it and knocked it out, and they brought it to a jeweler, and he honed it into a diamond, and now you're flashing it on your fucking ring. Ooh, monkey, monkey like. It's a trick, man. Who gives a fuck about that shiny thing, man? Shiny thing. Life is a fucking massive mystery, man. And the only way we're ever gonna at least get a grip on how to maneuver our way through it in a sensible or a pleasurable way.
Enjoyable.
We gotta tell the truth, man.
You know, I was gonna say that's actually another mind thing, is that they say we're entering into this age where it's a lot harder to lie, and the truth is known. It's harder to lie. We're moving into an age of truth, is where we're going.
Well, what the Mayans believed is that the Earth, in India, ancient India, they believed this, is that the humanity moves in cycles, and the cycles are called the yugas. And what we are now is in a stage called Kali Yuga, and Kali Yuga is like the worst. We're in the worst area, but we're about to enter into the age of enlightenment.
It's gotta get bad before it gets good, bro.
Exactly. We're in this area, this age of materialism and horrible, confusing war that makes no sense, completely nonsensical ideology. A president, the leader of the free world, who's a fucking retard. I mean, we are in literally a movie. Like, this is like a movie scenario. It's so stupid the way we're living our lives that it almost seems fake. Like, if you're a sensible person and you condensed the world today down to some two-hour movie, you would leave that movie going, God damn, I'm glad life isn't really like that.
Yeah.
Something's happening. I think the internet is a part of it. I think we look at the internet, we look at technology in general as being something that's innocent and benign. And I don't think so, man. I have a theory about technology that it's almost like a symbiotic life form, that we need it like it needs us. And that it dies off like old computers die off, like a fucking Apple, you know, one of those original ones that, you know, tan keyboard and the computer in the box and the floppy disk and all that shit. Those things are dead now. Those things are dead just like Neanderthals.
Right.
It's almost like we have a narrowly defined viewpoint of what life is. And it's almost like technology is a life form. And it's a life form that exists in a non-biological way that's connected through information, through the internet. And that we need it to stay alive, and it needs us to stay alive.
You know what I just...
We're completely dependent on it now. I mean, do you ever think about how dependent you are on technology? We're talking right now through, somehow or another, through a fucking power line?